Our universe is full of mysterious phenomena that often make physicists scratch their heads. I like to cover those topics on this channel, usually in the form of weird stars or interesting planets, in other words, large objects. But mysteries in science can also come in small packages, this particular one being a single atomic nucleus. But it wasn't just any nucleus. This one hit a detector traveling at 99%, followed by 21 nines the speed of light. Detected on October 15, 1991, at a detector operated by the University of Utah, the extreme energy of this particle, or ultra-high-energy cosmic ray, had the kinetic energy equivalent to a baseball traveling at 60 miles per hour. That's a single atomic nucleus with that power. The energy of this particle shocked scientists at the time, and to this day it's unclear just what could accelerate a particle of matter to that kind of speed. Since then, other particles with similar energies have been detected, though they remain rare. And oddly enough, recent studies have suggested that the particles may originate from a certain area within the constellation of Ursa Major. And there's also evidence that unlike most cosmic rays, which tend to be made up of protons or helium nuclei, these high-energy ones may in fact be iron nuclei, which adds to the mystery. Normal cosmic rays can be created in a number of different environments, perhaps most notably in supernovas, and they can even occasionally include antimatter particles such as antiprotons and positrons. But with ultra-high energy cosmic rays, the hypothesized sources include spinning black holes launching them, or pulsars or neutron stars, no one knows for sure. But two hypotheses for the origin of these particles are noteworthy because they involve abnormal states of matter. The first weirdness involves dark matter. Widely seen as one of the biggest unsolved mysteries of the universe, the abilities and properties of dark matter are not well understood, outside of the effects of its gravity on the normal matter of the universe. In a paper by Yuri Pavlov and Andre Grib, link in the description below, they suggest that there is a method for dark matter to decay and result in the creation of these high-energy cosmic rays. Dark matter is weakly interactive, usually. The paper describes a process where a heavy particle of dark matter can decay into two virtual particles, which can interact with normal matter. If these particles are near a black hole, one can fall into the black hole and the other eject it out, where it interacts with normal matter falling into the black hole. This could result in a high-energy proton ejected that may be consistent with a high-energy cosmic ray. But in the end, the idea suffers from anything related to the subject of dark matter. We just don't know what the stuff is, or in general, the ins and outs of how it works. And speaking of not knowing how a form of matter really works, brings us to the second option, which has never been seen, only theorized. It's called strange matter. This really deals with two forms of abnormal matter that may be present in neutron stars. A neutron star has gravity so great that normal atomic bonds aren't possible, leaving essentially a big ball of densely packed neutrons, hence the term neutron star. But there may be another state where the gravity is sufficient for the neutrons to break down into their constituent quarks, creating quark matter. The transition or combustion of a neutron star into a quark star is one possible source for the high-energy cosmic rays. As it combusts, the neutron star's magnetic field would collapse, releasing particles at very high energies. That might account for the rarity of high-energy cosmic rays. But again, this is a mechanism that isn't well understood, and the science of strange matter is still developing. In the end, the origin of these kinds of cosmic rays will likely be mysterious for a long time. All of the possible mechanisms for creating them are at the forefront of theoretical physics and astronomy, but the idea that something in this universe can accelerate a particle of matter to energies 40 million times greater than anything we can do in a particle accelerator is a humbling thought indeed. Thanks for listening. I am science fiction author, futurist, and inventor of the antimatter donut, John Michael Gaudier. Arthur C. Clarke got to be the inventor of the communication satellite. I get the anti-jelly donut, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.